Morning, Late Night Fam, welcome to another video. And today we will be doing some shopping. So, shopping is very important when it comes to car parts, especially for the Honda as well as the project car. I have bad news regarding the Honda. Well, the news has been coming on for at least 2 months, really. But 2 months ago, the master cylinder actually gave problems. And now, recently, the car has been standing still like 2 weeks. And I drove the car for one day and then let the car stand still again, and then when I wanted to pull the car out after 2 days, the clutch was laying on the floor completely, and even though I believe the clutch is still, it's not 100%, it's like whenever you placing your foot on the clutch and you're applying some force, only that last foot, like 20% at the bottom takes the clutch. Other than that, it's just wind you like applying force on. And first on the way to Belleville to sell this project car's previous set of springs to one of my subscribers, and then from there I'll be heading to Masterpart in Strand, because there's a guy there that was there, one of my friends, he hooked me up with a master and slave cylinder for the Honda VTEC. So it's gonna be a very long day of shopping, and I bought the sensors for this car as well. So I bought the sensor next to the block, I bought the sensor above the oil filter, and I bought the sensor for the reverse lights. So hopefully after the sensor installations on this car, then this car will be working 100% fine, and that buzzing sound you guys hear right now on the dash will be completely gone. Regarding my gauges, my supplier, or the guy that sponsors me, he's waiting on his supplier for the LED strip light for my gauges. So the gauges is already done, he has the design. I posted it on YouTube as well as a normal post. You guys have probably seen the design. I hope you guys like the design, and please do make use of their custom, because they are amazing. They are very unique, and they can make your car very unique as well, so definitely make use of it. I'll update you guys once we are on our way to Strand, because I'm still in about halfway out of San Jose at the moment, on my way to Belleville. The guy said this location I'm driving to his work, drop it off there, get the cash, and from there I'll be heading straight to Strand to go get the Martin station under. I'll be heading back home, and later tonight I might have a surprise for you guys, but this will be most probably in the next clip or in the same video, I'm not sure yet, I'm still deciding. But if everything goes according to plan, you guys gonna like what I'm gonna reveal to you guys, no lies. So stay tuned, you guys enjoy the video, and bear with me with today's video, because I know you guys don't like it when I talk a lot, but enjoy the road. Just dropped off the springs, and the guy was happy with the springs. He's gonna, he has the project car himself, and he will be fitting the springs in his project car. So it's very nice that we can actually help each other out, because he's going from the one car to the other car, to another friend's car, to the cousin's car, to another buyer's car. It's nice how we can like keep this friendship and this channel like going, because a lot of the parts I actually sell to my subscribers, and I'm really grateful for you guys supporting me. But now at the moment, I'm just heading to Strand. I have to get that Honda sorted as well. Hopefully it will be in the week. It won't be today though. Hopefully in the week. And then, to Ashley's dad, I actually mentioned about the battery, because at the moment, I am driving with the Honda's battery in the yellow tank, and I feel like it's unnecessary, because each time I want to drive with the Honda, I have to put the battery in the Honda, I have to put the battery in this car again, and it's all time like this. But I really hope he's gonna buy me a battery, or gonna at least get me a battery. Then I can actually have a battery in each car. And hopefully the GTI will be coming back in this week or next week. I'm sorry for the little bit of content on the GTI this far, but we're still waiting on it, unfortunately. And yeah, I'll update you guys as soon as I get the parts at Masterparts. and then I'll be heading home and doing the installation on the sensors on this car. So enjoy the drive with me once again.
Okay.
Moments later,
I arrived at home a few minutes ago, and these are the parts I actually bought for the Honda. All these parts laying right here are actually for the Honda, because I just felt like I need to get this car up and running 100%. And after this, the car will be needing a service. It doesn't actually need a service, but I feel like I want to service the car. So I'll explain to you guys everything we have right here. Firstly, we have the antifreeze. I usually always buy a 5 litre antifreeze because I don't like to actually mix my antifreeze with a little bit of water. So we have the antifreeze. I bought the green one. You get like all different colors. You get the green, red and blue one at Master Parts. I usually buy the Midas brand, but Jose recommended that this Master Parts antifreeze is in Dubai. Also, I actually bought this as well. I bought the radiator flush. Radiator flush is very important because I need to clean out my system, and my water is very, very dirty in my system, so I'm definitely gonna make use of this. So I have that. Then I bought me the thermostat. I had to buy me the thermostat because the car, okay, the car isn't overheating, but because the fan is going on a little bit late and the water is pushing out in front, everything like that, I decided, okay, I would rather want to buy myself a new thermostat, because I know everything in the cooling department will be sorted out. So we have the thermostat right there, and I bought myself the radiator cap. Just note, when you have a I almost said Mark 1, if you have a Honda and the radiator cap is 1.1, just make sure you buy the right radiator cap, which is 1.1 as well. So I bought myself a radiator cap. I actually replaced the radiator cap a few weeks ago. I'm not sure how the radiator cap's condition is at the moment. That's the reason why I bought a new one. Then obviously I bought some sealant, because whenever I'm going to replace the thermostat, I'll be needing some sealant. And I bought the fan switch. Fan switch you can usually buy at Honda itself. I actually recommend buying the fan switch and the thermostat at Honda itself, but unfortunately, me running on a low budget, I actually bought the thermostat at Master Parts, and I bought the fan switch at Midas. And the reason for that is because Master Parts didn't have a fan switch, and they had the thermostat, and that's the reason why I bought them apart. But both are still very, very quality items, because apparently these thermostats came out on the BMW, apparently said by Master Parts employees. And we have the brake fluid whenever I'm gonna bleed the clutch, because I don't have a lot of brake fluid left, and that's the reason why I need to throw in this whenever I'm gonna bleed out the clutch. Then we have, I think this one is the slave cylinder. So here we have the slave cylinder, and then we have the master cylinder. The master cylinder is the main reason why my clutch is laying there at the bottom. But I know later customs, he one time gonna replace everything on his car, and that's the reason why I bought everything. Like, there's no problem with my cooling system, and there's no problem with my slave cylinder, but because I'm gonna do everything and I want the car to be 110%, I'm replacing all of this to make sure the car is 100%. But for now, let's head outside and go check on the switches and the sensors I bought for the Mark 1. The sensors I was referring to were this sensor right here, which is the one on top of the oil filter. This one here on the block, and then as well this one on the gearbox right there. You can barely see that one. This switch here makes the rear reverse lights go on. And then I'm not sure about this sensor, but I think it's the sensor that's faulty, that's causing the light to go on the dash. Lodge's right here, so he's gonna test for Jolly's wheels. But today I'm just gonna replace those sensors. Very, very easy. You just take a normal spanner and you just remove these sensors and put the other ones in, and it's just plug and play. So I'm gonna do that right away off camera, and we can see if it was actually the sensor, because if it was the sensor, then the light on the dashboard should be off. I got all the sensors replaced. I got this one replaced, I got this one replaced right there, and I got that one replaced right there. So that one was actually the sensor on the gearbox why the car's reverse lights didn't work. Because after I installed that, the reverse lights actually went on the car, and then the oil light on the dash didn't go on yet, so I was probably thinking it's this one or this one, and that's the reason why I replaced both of them. But the only way I'll be able to see is if I actually go and drive with the car and see if the oil light goes on after a nice long drive. But Lois is gonna put the ignition on right now and just put the car in reverse to show you guys that the reverse lights actually work. Put it in reverse, Lois. There we go. So the reverse lights works 100%, and then the oil light on the dash is off. And that's a big achievement for us. Now we will just be waiting for our new gauges. And then I think the next thing I might be tackling on this car might be the window mechanism. I might remove the door board, off, and just check what's wrong with the mechanism, because maybe it is fixable. If it's not fixable, then unfortunately I'll have to buy a new one. I know that one right there as well is faulty, because I'll be needing new window winders, and I'll be needing new window, I don't know what you call that, where to turn that thing, because the back doors don't have one. Although I do actually have two laying around here somewhere. I know here's one right here that I actually got in one of my uncle's collections, but I would like all four to be the same in the car, so I might just go and buy like a set of four, because the front ones actually looks really really bad and I don't like it like that. But that will be all for today though.
Many minutes later.
I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Today's video was kind of successful, because I actually got the tail lights or the reverse lights to work, and that's a big achievement. But guys, unfortunately the oil light on the dash keeps on going on. I have no idea why it's doing that. Just note I replaced the sensor on the oil filter as well as alongside the block there by the gearbox, that one. So I replaced both, and you guys can see in the video I actually replaced both, but the oil light is still going on, and I don't understand why it's going on. So maybe if you guys have any advice, please do comment down below why it's still going on. Well, the surprise actually I had planned for you guys didn't actually pull through. I'm just waiting for the guy. He's actually working late, so I'm still arranging a time or a day to meet up with him. I might just meet up with him tomorrow. But if I do, then I'll update you guys and I'll reveal the surprise. If there's no surprise, then you guys know it wasn't like successful or anything like that. Or it didn't the deal wasn't sealed. But guys, please like this video and please subscribe to my channel. And please do comment down below what you guys think I should do to the yellow car next. Because at this stage, I'm almost done with all the mechanical stuff. I still have a few things to do. I still have oil leak. And oh yeah guys, many of you guys have a valve cover for me, like a Mark 1 valve cover. I'm very interested in the Mark 1 valve cover, because the Mark 1 valve cover I have currently on my car is causing a leak, and I don't like the leak on the car, because it's very it's embarrassing, because unfortunately at this stage I can't do anything like regarding the leak, because I don't have an extra valve cover. But it's very embarrassing when you go stand in someone's yard and you pull away and there's an oil leak. It's it's a bad reflection of my character. And I actually don't like it, because I'm kind of a mechanic and I work on my own cars. Now it looks bad. Lately customs looks very bad. So guys, if you guys can maybe sponsor me a valve cover, or maybe if you guys have a price tag on it, please link me up. I really appreciate it. Guys, hope you guys enjoyed this video. And please do remember, stop racing and go stars.